Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Make Maharashtra, in which you'll get more educational videos. You can watch it. Now, as I told you, there are many more scientists. They have done their research on the sliding contact bearing. So here is the some history. I'll explain. This law of viscosity was developed. Just watch. And in 1883, Petrov equation, that we are going to study, and that will be totally about the bearing frictional torque generated on the bearing, that we need to find out. In 1883 and 85, Towers reports about the frictional experiment. Then 86, Reynolds equation was investigated. And currently in 1932, the Mackey, that journal bearing friction in the regime of thin film lubricant. Lubrication. So in that he had made his research. So all this researcher, out of that we just focus on Petrov and Reynolds as per the syllabus. So as I told you, the Petrov equation, I derived the Petrov equation. Now I'll move toward the Reynolds equation, which is very critical part of this sliding contact bearing syllabus. So just keep in mind and be focused whatever I am telling for this Reynolds. Now see, Petrov equation we have seen. Now we'll move toward the Reynolds equation. Now Reynolds, what he has suggested, you can just consider this diagram currently. So what this diagram shows, it shows that this is the sliding contact bearing, and Reynolds says that as the Petrovs explain about the frictional torque generated in between shaft and bearing. Now the Reynolds, he has explained the three parameters by this sliding contact bearing. First one is a pressure gradient. What will be the pressure generated by the shaft and which will taken by the lubricating oil? That will be the pressure gradient he has calculated. Then second one is he has calculated the velocity gradient. At the time of the rotation of the shaft, what will be the velocity in the particle of the lubricant will occur. So that will be the velocity gradient. And third is what will be the flow rate as per their velocity. That three parameters are calculated by this Reynolds. Clear? For that, he has taken this element, square element. You can see this element dy with respect to height h, this fluid element. And on the basis of this fluid element, he has calculated this all the three gradients. So just check it, this figure. Now this figure is about this cube, that fluid element is situated in between shaft and bush. You can see here. So just he has named the notations for this block. First, he said that this will be the height h, correct? Height h, this. Then flow of lubricant from this side, pressure into with respect to y-axis with respect to z. 3D, three conditions he has considered, that is x, y, z direction he has considered. According to direction, the pressure is acting p into dy. Into z, dz, correct? So because of x direction, dx is not there, correct? And for that, equal and opposite forces, p plus daba p by daba x, pressure with respect to x axis, because of this dx is there here, correct? Now p plus daba p by daba x into dx into dy into dz. Here taken the derivative, so equal and opposite force, I think you understood. Second, from top side of the cube in the direction of the flow of lubricant, you can see he has mentioned the equation. Before that, we'll study the bottom side. So bottom side, he has explained the tau x, that is shear stress in the x direction with respect to dx dz. So y is zero at the bottom side because it is zero na reference. So tau x into dx into dz. So equal and opposite force, tau x, you can see here, plus daba tau x by daba y with respect to y distance into dy into dx dz. So this will be the notification he has mentioned for the elemental area, correct? So I hope you understood this, equal and opposite force and top, bottom and side force. Generally elemental area, the question is why this area is considered. Because what happened, you can see out of this shaft and bearing surface, the most smaller area is this much. So that's why he has taken this for pressure, velocity and flow rate calculation. So he elaborate in terms of the dx, dy, dz in with respect to axis of the direction, correct? So these are the three forces and these are the indications for the Reynolds equation. So let us see one by one as he has explained the pressure gradient. So I'll make here the mark for the pressure gradient. You can see, I hope, just try to understand. Now here he has combined the force, equal and opposite force, such as you can see this P dy dz, it is going to right side, correct? So he considered the right side forces first, P dy dz plus this right side forces, top side of the cube, tau x plus daba tau x by daba y into dy into dx dz, correct? Right side. Now left side is minus this P plus daba P by daba x into dx in bracket dy dz minus, again this will goes in left side, na, tau x dx dz, which is equal to 0, correct? Now he has just considered the forces direction, accordingly I have written over here. Now then he has converted here in simplify format. You can see this P into dy dz as it is plus tau x dx dz, this minus term is considered for this case, and I'll show you what he has considered. P into dy dz plus tau x, this term. Now daba tau x by daba y into dx dy, just converted left side, and total terms are converted into left side and compare with the 0, correct? Now this again modified, you can check this daba tau x by daba y into dx dy dz, the terms are cancelled and remaining terms are minus daba t by this daba p by daba x dx dy dz is equal to 0. Therefore the equation for the x axis, that pressure gradient for x axis, daba p by daba x is equal to daba tau x, shear stress with respect to x direction, is divided by daba y. So this is the derivative of pressure gradient which he has calculated for the elemental, selected elemental area. Now we know the viscosity equation, this tau is equal to mu into, that is absolute viscosity, du by dy, du is nothing but velocity with respect to distance. So we have considered here u, why? Because u is the velocity, you can see here u is the velocity with respect to height y. So this tau x value I will have to put here, understood? This tau x value I will have to put here. So therefore the equation will be, you can see equation will be daba p by daba x here is equal to daba tau x, that is daba by daba y, u is nothing but mu into du by dy, correct? So this will be the equation he has kept. And then daba p by daba x, which can be directly converted, see daba p by daba x is equal to mu, out of the box, is equal to daba square, double derivative of velocity with respect to y square. So this will be the equation for pressure gradient in a x direction, pressure distribution, this equation we have derived. So this is pressure gradient first part which we have covered, correct? Now for y direction, generally what happened, the cube is having distance height of y, that dy, so y direction is always 0. We will not get the pressure in between that area, so that's why we'll have to consider the pressure gradient for the velocity is daba p, pressure gradient with respect to y is 0. And for z direction, of course here we have seen that daba p by daba x is equal to mu into daba square u by daba y square. Now u is for x, v is for y, u v w, w is for z. So here they have mentioned for pressure gradient daba p by daba z is equal to mu into, instead of u, just daba square w by daba z square. This is pressure gradient equation for according to their direction additions are made and all the terms are taking left side and converted into the equation by using the law of viscosity. We'll get the final answer that dabba p by dabba x is equal to mu into dabba square u by dabba y square, and same for y and z axis. Now second part, velocity distribution. Now velocity distribution dabba p by dabba x direction is equal to mu into dabba square u by dabba y square, correct? Now velocity, how I can get? Very simple question, how I can get the velocity from this equation, from given? I'll write, see, this is dabba square u. If I 2 times integration of this, then I'll get, first time integration I'll get dabba u by dabba y, second integration u is equal to, correct? So twice integration I will have to make, then I'll get u is nothing but velocity. So that will be the velocity gradient we need to calculate here, integration of the above equation with respect to y. So first integration dabba u by dabba y is equal to 1 by u, sorry, 1 by mu into dabba p by dabba x into y plus c1. Then again integrating dabba u by dabba y is u is equal to 1 by mu dabba p by dabba x, integrate y square by 2 plus c1 into y plus c2. Then here we will get the c1 and c2, will put the boundary condition, that is all are 0 because base we'll have to consider. Therefore by putting the 0 value we'll get the direct equation by putting with respect to c1 and c2. You just remember this one, velocity is equal to 1 by 2 mu dabba p by dabba x in bracket y square minus hy plus u by height h into y. This will be the velocity gradient. See, again I am explaining double integration we did, and by that is integration we'll get this value directly. Clear? You can write the direct value, no problem. In examination 100% they will ask the derivation on Reynolds equation. So in case of this you need to write directly, it's okay, but by first step will be this. Clear? Next will be the flow rate. Now in case of the flow rate, what will be the flow rate? Now there is a direction x, y, z, so both directional flow rates are there. So here we'll have to consider the flow rates. Qx, flow rate in x direction, is equal to with respect to height h u into dy into 1. So just by integrating with respect to 0 to h, u value already we have calculated in previous slide, this will be 1 minus 2 mu velocity gradient, and that velocity gradient take as an input for this, and by converting this we'll get the qx, this term, minus h cube 12 mu into dp by dx plus u h by 2. Now here qx is the flow rate for x direction. As I told you, y direction is 0 and z direction, again instead of u capital, u v w, w is there, remaining things are same, correct? So by this way we have calculated a flow rate. Equate this equation, I'll consider this three equation, dabba by dabba x in case of the x direction flow rate, dabba by dabba y in case of the y direction flow rate, dabba by dabba z in case of z direction flow rate is equal to 0, and just put the values by equating 0, by equating with respect to 0. So we'll get direct equation. You can see this equation, that is dabba by dabba x in bracket h cube dp dabba p by dabba x, this is for x. Then for z, dabba by dabba z, h cube dabba p by dabba z instead of x, here z, is equal to 6 times mu absolute viscosity in bracket u into, this is for x and this is for z, u into dabba h by dabba x plus w into dabba h by dabba z, instead of x z is there. So this will be the Reynolds equation. You can directly write down by the using the steps, and so such kind of the Reynolds equation given by the Reynolds, but there are some lacunas are in the equation, or assumptions are in the equation. Due to that, this Reynolds equation cannot be used for the solving numerical. I'll tell you few Reynolds assumptions, just listen. The first assumption is some assumption. In 2015, they have asked the question on assumptions, write a note on assumption or write an assumption for 2 marks. So first assumption is, he has considered the lubricating oil which follows the Newton's law of viscosity. So Newton's law of viscosity is shear stress, we have written, directly proportional to velocity with respect to height. That is, we have converted that tau is equal to mu into absolute viscosity dv by dh. So this will be the Newton's law of viscosity, correct? So it indicate that the shear stress is always directly proportional to velocity with respect to height, first assumption. Second assumption he made, the inertia forces in the fluid films are neglected, which is not possible generally, practically, because inertia is generated due because of its motion. And he has suggested assumed the inertia forces are negligible. Third assumption is the fluid flow is laminar. Okay, in practical also it is not possible. Fourth assumption, the viscosity of the fluid is constant throughout the film. It means that at the time of rotation it will be constant from this end to this end, everywhere it is constant, which is again not possible. So this is assumption. And last assumption is a fluid is incompressible, which is also not considerable practically. Clear? So these are the basic assumptions which he had taken. But the finally which we have derived the equation, this is two dimensional equation for the Reynolds, and generally we are not using this equation for the calculation because it is not feasible to calculate. I'll revise the things which we have covered. So first one is the pressure distribution, the forces direction accordingly we'll have to find out this value dabba p by dabba x in x direction. The next one is a dabba p by dabba y, dabba p by dabba z. For velocity distribution we have taken input as a pressure gradient and double integrate it, we'll get the equation in terms of velocity, and this velocity taken as an input for flow rate with respect to 0 to h. By putting this I'll get the qx flow direction in x, y and z, y is 0, and by equating this three forces I'll get one equation, and that equation is this, and this is called as a Reynolds equation. I hope you understood this thing. Thank you.